We're now honoured indeed to have a very special exclusive. For the first time on British television, please welcome Tom York, Plan B.
Pissed off with you cause you've been acting childish, T. When the fuck you gonna grow up, man? Stop having these fights with me. Deep down I know we're cool, but sometimes I wonder, would I really give a fuck if you were 6 feet under? I look at you as a friend, but when it comes down to it, it's blatant. Me and you ain't tight like the way you are with Jason. And you don't listen to me like the way you listen to him. That makes me think you don't respect me, that's how the dissing begins. Every time we meet, we're at each other's throats like a couple of bitches. Hate the way you try, go on like a fuck, that's some thick shit. No one day you'll sort yourself out cause you ain't stupid. I just hope that that day ain't that far away cause my life's moving at a fast rate. Picking up pace, heading towards the right place. I don't wanna leave you behind, but I can feel my heart change as every day goes by. I start to realize who my friends are. If you're one of them, prove it, fix up.
Couldn't get along today. Now we couldn't get along today.
Again, my friend, you managed to rattle someone's cage, but for once it ain't mine. This time it's Dave's. Fuck me, I thought we were bad, but you and him are worse. Falling out over petty shit like money, weed and birds. Talking about if you never saw each other again, it would be too soon. I can't really talk though, sometimes I feel that way too. I'm just glad that me and you have sorted out our differences. Now we can finally be on the level as you like to put it, just circle. So how's your life, man? Daily, you seem really down. What's it like living on that council estate in South? I know you got that big fuck off dog to protect you, but it ain't your manner, man. What's wrong with your head, dude? The way you go on, blood, you need to be careful. Hey, don't give me that shit about it's all cool, just be careful. Look, I've got to go. When you're in the ends next, make sure you check me. Hi, blood, cool. See you next week.
Couldn't get along today. Couldn't get along today.
No one else, cause today I got a call from Greg. The first thing he said was, hey B, you're not gonna believe this, man, but Tony's dead. And at first I didn't, then I heard Tony's voice and I knew he was serious, so I didn't have a choice. And suddenly it hit me and I went silent, lost for words. So I listened to him describe how you died. I felt the surge of overwhelming sadness. Those fucking bastards, why they have to kill you, man? It's madness. I keep a picture in your face. First time I seen it scared, as I imagine you dropping from that balcony, falling through the air. I don't know whether you fell trying to escape or whether you was pushed up. But whatever they did, it was enough to get you more than shook up. All I know is that they turned up at your flat whilst you were sleeping. I seriously intended on giving you a beating. That bitch you live with must have had something to do with it as well. She wanted you out of the yard. Why the fuck else would that dog of yours be locked in another room? I find it far too convenient, that slag must have knew that they was coming to do you something bad. I just can't take this, it's driving me mad. I just can't believe you're gone and never felt this sad.
Blah, blah, blah.
I fucking love you, man.
Couldn't get along today. Now we couldn't get along today.
You're gone, nothing will ever be the same. Your death was a tragedy in every kind of way. I can't comprehend all the time we wasted on being angry at each other instead of just getting along. It's wrong, and it reminds me of how you left the last of days. Cause when you died, we didn't see his ass for days. And those days have turned to months, and now those months have turned to years. Thought to be a sack, and still we're holding back the tears. I say we haven't seen Dave for years, but we have, except it ain't really him. David, we knew we'd never take crack or heroin. It hit him hard just like it did for Jace. You and him were like brothers and his heart lies in empty space. Cause you'll never be replaced. And we all feel the same. All we have is love and respect when someone mentions your name. So know this, just before I hang up the line for the last time, we love you and you're forever on our minds.